meet my new friends, Patricia and Eliza. Really don't know if those names suit them. I might change them later on. But anyways, we have a professional address forms in the studio now. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new around here, my name is Madison. I'm an Instagram creator, pastime blogger, and current high school fashion design teacher. And here on YouTube, I film sewing videos and tutorials along with other tidbits of information, all in all to really share my love and passion for fashion and sewing with you all. And today I am so excited for a new sewing video, specifically for those of you who want to learn more about pattern making and creating custom patterns to specifically fit you and your size and your body. And we are going to be doing that with these two lovely mannequins. So I am so excited to finally have professional dress forms in the studio. If you guys have watched my past videos, you know that I had a dress form, but it was really just a decorative foam dress form that was fairly close to my size, but definitely is completely different when you have a professional dress form. And I am so excited about these, and it is all thanks to Mannequin Mall, who kindly sent these to me so that I could use them for my videos and for my projects. So for the majority of my projects, I'm going to be using the size 6 since that is the closest to my size, but I also got a size 8 for additional projects in the future. And they were so nice to give you guys a discount code as well, so if you check the description below, you can find that discount code to get 10% off of your own dress form, so you can start designing your own custom fitted garments at home and live out your dreams of being your own fashion designer, which we all strive to, right? So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to drape a basic bodice for a dress. So essentially, we are going to be making a simple classic A-line dress, maybe with a couple of tweaks here and there to add a little bit of flair. But this is the style of dress that I grew up sewing, typically from patterns, but I also had made my own patterns a lot growing up to make this specific style. So I wanted to show you guys how to achieve that today, specifically using a dress form to get the perfect fit, and then to also have a pattern that you can use for all these other projects in the future, which is so great. Once you have a piece that really fits you, you can use it to adapt it to different designs and projects for other things. So for today's project, we are going to be using the size 6 mannequin to make this dress right here. And we are going to be using the mannequin to drape the bodice to get all of the kind of tucks and all of the darts perfect to create the neckline, the armholes, all of that, because the bodice is usually the most important part of any garment because that is where we have the most curves and we need a fit that is flattering to us. And then for the skirt, we are going to be drafting it ourselves, but really the skirt just relies on math and widths and lengths, so there's no crazy drafting there. We might add sleeves or we might keep it sleeveless. It really depends on how much fabric I have for the fabric I chose specifically for this project. But I hope you guys enjoy this, following along so that you can drape your own dress and learn how to create a bodice specifically for your size using a dress form. So let's get started.
So the first thing I always do before I start draping is add tape to my dress form. This allows me to have style lines, which help me to place the darts and any curves or tucks in the correct place because they give me lines that I'm able to actually trace over on my muslin. So this is super helpful. So once my tape lines are in place, I pinned my muslin to my mannequin. And if you remember, you pin your muslin or whatever mock-up fabric you are using across grain because it has more stretch, and that's how you actually get a good drape on your mannequin. So once my muslin is pinned to the shoulder of my dress form, I start to fit the front darts. So I'm actually going to only be draping half of the front bodice since it's going to be cut on the fold. So all I have to do is draw that center line where it'll be cut on the fold, draw the neckline, draw the armholes where I want them to be placed, pin my front dart so that it actually fits to the mannequin, and then create my side seam. And then that will be turned into my actual pattern piece. So it's really important that once all your pins are put into place and everything is draped to fit the mannequin as you want it to, that you actually go and draw in all your lines, because that will become the outline of your actual pattern. Then you can cut off all of the excess so you can actually start to see it take shape, and then you can remove it from your dress form.
Thank you. Okay, so this is my bodice. I decided to only drape half of it. It's really not necessarily in all designs to drape the entire bodice, especially since this bodice will be cut on the fold and it will be mirrored on both sides. So this is one side of the bodice, and I always like to kind of just drape the things on myself after I've draped them on a mannequin just to check it. The whole part about draping is that you can actually sew a mock-up of the bodice or the design before you actually cut it out of your real fabric to make sure that you've tweaked any sizing that you need to. So that's why I kind of just like lay it on myself. So the one thing I know I'm going to change is I'm not going to make this dart quite as deep, and that the curve, it's very like curved for the dart, so I'm just going to widen it a bit and straighten out that line, and then everything will be good and it should fit perfectly. So then we will go cut this out and mark it on our fabric and actually start sewing the bodice. And then we'll also go in and either do interfacing for the neckline and for the armholes, or if we add sleeves, we don't have to have interfacing. But I think I'm actually going to line this bodice because I prefer lined bodices to interfacing. So yeah.
So before I went and cut this out of my actual fabric, I went in with a Sharpie and a ruler to straighten out all of my lines after draping it on my bodice to fix all of my curves and also cut off any crooked excess. And I also went in and straightened that dart that was a little too curved because I knew that it would give me a better fit if it were straight. And that way I have a really great pattern piece that's my draped fabric to work with. And one thing about draping it on your mannequin is that this piece doesn't have seam allowance built into it, so whenever I lay it on my fabric to cut it out, I'm actually going to add my seam allowance, which is typically about half an inch. But before I do that, I wanted to sew my dart closed to fit it back on to my dress form again and make sure that my dart placement and size actually fit how I wanted to, and it did. And then I forgot that I actually hadn't draped the back part of my bodice, so here we go. The exact same steps as draping the front. You pin it along the bias at the shoulder, you pin your back dart, you create your back center seam, you create your shoulder line, your side seam, your armhole, and you make sure that everything is the same size and fits to the front bodice piece. And then once it's all draped and pinned, then you can start cutting it out. One thing to keep in mind when draping a bodice is that your shoulder seams and your side seams have to match up, so it's always important to measure what your side seams for your front bodice are and make sure that the side seam is the exact same length for the back. Same thing for the shoulders. And also, one of the huge parts about draping this on the bias is that it gives your fabric, like I said, some stretch, and so you want to make sure to pull your fabric and actually fit it to your mannequin. That way you get the best fit on yourself. And again, always keep checking all of those measurements to make sure that everything is going to align and fit exactly as it should. And after draping my bodice back, I went back in to straighten out again all of my lines, to straighten out my dart, my side seams, and the bottom, just to make sure everything is ready and that it also aligns with my front bodice for my shoulders and my side seams. And now we're ready to actually start tracing it out and cutting it from our actual fabric. So like I mentioned before, I only draped half of my front bodice because it will be cut on the fold. As you can see here, I placed it on the fold of my fabric, and as I was cutting it out, I also added half an inch of seam allowance to my bodice to make sure that when I sew it with my 5/8 seam allowance, everything still fits perfectly to size. So after it's cut out, I also went in to place all of my dart markings to the front of my bodice to make sure that I sew those in the correct placements. And we're going to repeat that exact same process for the back of the bodice, except the back of the bodice is not cut on the fold, it's just cut normally. And I actually usually add about 1 inch to 1.5 inches of extra fabric to my center back, just to make sure I have plenty of fabric when adding my zipper later on. So same thing, we added seam allowance all the way around, and then we also go in and mark our dart placements. And because I decided to line this entire bodice, I went in and repeated the exact same steps for the front and the back of the bodice on a lining fabric. So just tracing out those exact same pieces of my bodice that I already cut out, since they already had seam allowance, cut them out of my lining, and then those will eventually be sewn inside of my bodice so that all of the seams are nice and hidden on the inside. Next, we're going to go pin all of our darts along our dart placement lines for our bodice front, bodice back, and all of our lining pieces. And then we'll set those aside while we cut out our skirt, and then we'll take it all to the sewing machine and start sewing it all together. And next up, it's time to make the skirt. So the skirt just requires length and width measurements. And for this specific skirt, I wanted to cut a few corners. So I'm actually using the side selvage of my fabric as my hem so that I don't actually have to hem it. So that is what you see me doing here, making sure that I have that selvage at the bottom. And then I created this skirt, I'm pretty sure, to be about 30 inches wide in width so that when it's gathered, it's still a decent skirt size. And then I made it a length that was a little bit past my knee. So that was just my own measurement. So now that all of our pieces are cut out, we can take them to the machine and start sewing them all together. And this was my first project that I actually got to use my brand new Janome sewing machine, and I am so excited about it. It has so many cool features. So anyways, here you see me sewing all of my darts together on my front and back pieces for my bodice, and then we will start working on the skirt. So for this dress, I decided to add pockets, so I cut them off camera, but here I'm putting them placement-wise about 4 inches down from the waist on my skirt, so the pockets are sewn to the sides of both the front and the back pieces before the side seams are sewn, and this is what actually allows you to create the pocket that when you're sewing your side seams, you just sew around the curve of the pocket, and that creates the hidden pocket in the side seams of your skirt. So next we're going to give all of our seams a nice press, all of our darts a great press, and all of our pockets we're going to press to the side before we actually start sewing all of the side seams on all of our pieces. And then I decided to go over to my serger and finish off all of my raw edges for my skirt before I actually started sewing it all together. That way I didn't have to do it afterwards. And again, serging your seams is always an optional step, and there are many ways to actually finish seams besides serging if you don't have a serger or an overlock machine. And now we're ready to sew the side seams of our skirt. So as you can see, I'm sewing around the curve of my pocket, and then I'm continuing down the side seam of my skirt. And this is what actually creates the ability to have a pocket in the side seams of your skirt. It's a super easy way to add pockets to literally everything. And now it's time to start assembling the bodice. So we have our front bodice piece with all of our darts sewn into place, and we have our two back bodice pieces with the darts sewn into place as well. So all we do is lay them right sides together, matching up the shoulder seams and the side seams. And after those are put into place, we are then going to sew a side seam at our sides and attach the shoulders to each other. And we're going to do the same thing for the lining pieces.
So we have the bodice all sewn. We are going to fit it to the mannequin just to see if we need to take up any seams anywhere. I'm pretty confident that I will have a pretty good fit since we drafted for the mannequin and my size. So let's see. Right. Wow, that is amazing. Oh my gosh, the fit is so good. I don't think I've ever gotten a bodice fit this, like, well. But it's totally different when you are actually using a mannequin that really is your size and that fits you, and you can draft your garment directly off of the mannequin. I mean, it's a game changer, honestly. Okay, so this is how everything's fitting. It looks pretty good. It definitely is a little loose in some areas, so I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the side seams in a little bit at the bottom, so I'm just going to taper them down so they're not so straight. I don't mind the front darts. I think the front darts are perfect how they are, so I'm just going to taper down the sides.
Now that we have sewn all of our side seams and shoulder seams together, we're just going to give them a nice press. And because I ended up taking in more of my side seams, I'm just going to trim off my excess so there isn't bulky fabric on the inside. Now it's time to sew the lining into our bodice, and there's multiple ways that you can do this, but for me, I always start by pinning it around my neckline where I pin right sides together. I'm gonna sew around my neckline, and then what I actually ended up doing is I ripped out my side seams because I forgot I wanted to sew it along the side seams as well. So anyways, you'll see that later on, but for now, we start by sewing it along our neckline so that when we turn it right side out, all of those seams will be nice and hidden on the inside, and the neckline will just be nice and flat and finished. Now the important part about sewing a curve is that you clip it afterwards, that way when you turn your fabric right side out, everything lies nice and flat along the curve, and then you give it a nice press along the neckline. So off camera, I ripped out my side seam so that I could sew my lining to my arms, and this is going to allow me to completely flip my bodice right side out to hide all of those seams on the inside, and then I'm going to go in and re-sew my side seams by placing them right sides together, matching up those seams for under the arm, sewing my lining pieces together, sewing my front bodice pieces together, and because I sewed the lining this way, all of the seams will actually be hidden on the inside of my bodice, and no seams will be visible. It is fantastic, and that is why I love to line my bodices. So here's what the bodice looks like after the lining has been sewn. All of the seams are hidden on the inside, and this is the magic of sewing that I absolutely love. We're gonna give all the side seams another nice press since we re-sewed them in a different way. Press all of our armholes and neckline, and just make sure everything is ready to attach the skirt to the bodice. Now we're gonna set our sewing machine up to do a basting stitch, which is just the highest stitch width. You all know that I do basting stitches and gathering in literally every single project video, so here we are at it again, adding some basting stitches, doubling them, putting them on top of each other, gathering it up, and adding it as our gather skirt to our bodice. So as in many of my past projects, you all know that I like to sandwich my gathers in between my lining of my bodice. So I usually go in and press the bottom hem of my bodice up about half an inch on both my lining and my outer shell. And that way I get all of those raw edges nice and encased and sandwiched over my gathers, as you will see in the next clip. So So all of our gathers have been made off camera, and now it's time to encase those gathers with my bodice. So this is what I call sandwiching, is that I basically just stick the gathers of the skirt in between the lining and the outer shell of my bodice, and then I pin that into place along where I folded and pressed that bottom of my bodice about up half an inch. That way, when you look on the inside of the dress, you literally don't have any seams anywhere. Everything is encased in the lining or finished really nice and well, and it makes pieces just fit a lot better to yourself. Alright, after our gathers of our skirt have been sandwiched into our bodice, we just take it over to the sewing machine and sew those down along where the pins are placed. Now that my bodice and skirt are connected, I wanted to fit it to my dress form just to make sure that everything was laying and fitting as it should. And of course it did, because it was drafted specifically for this dress form. So here's what it looks like, all sewn together before the zipper.
Okay, so my dress is fit onto my mannequin and it is definitely a perfect fit. I'm so excited about this. So all that is left is for me to put the zipper in and then it will be finished, which is super exciting. We got to skip the step of hemming the dress since we used the selvage side edges of our fabric, which are, the selvage is usually finished, so you don't have to hem it unless you really want to, but I try to cut as many corners as I can. So this is where we're going to place our zipper and kind of take up that fabric. So in order to do that, I'm going to put the dress on inside out so I can pin it and mark it for where the zipper should actually go. Okay, so once I have all my pins into place for the back seam of my dress, I always like to put my pins in so that it kind of fits along the curve of the back, because our back's really not straight up and down. So you could install a zipper basically straight flat against your back, but I feel like garments fit a lot better when the zipper can actually curve to the curve of your back. So my pins are put into place kind of where the back of the mannequin is curving a bit. I'm going to go draw a line on every side so I have that marked. And I'm using this fun little pin, which isn't actually a sewing pin, but I learned about this pin in college. So it's one of the friction ball pins. It's one of the erasable ones, so I have it in blue and purple. The cool thing about these erasable pins is that you can draw on fabric with them, and then when you apply heat to it with an iron, they disappear. So it's amazing. I usually use magic markers, which disappear with air or with water, but these are really great because they disappear once you apply heat to them. There we go. So we are going to go take the pins out, take it to our machine, put a basting stitch in. So I always sew up the back of my garments. So before I put in a zipper, I always sew the back of my garments closed with a basting stitch if I'm using a regular zipper. If I'm doing an invisible zipper, it's different. But for this dress, we are doing a regular zipper. So I will baste the back together, then sew my zipper on, and then rip out my basting stitch. It's a really easy, kind of foolproof way of installing a zipper.
Thank you. So here is the reveal of the completed dress. So I have to say that this dress is probably the best fit I have ever gotten from any of my designs, even those I created from personally drafted slopers. So that is the difference that a dress form truly makes when designing the perfect fit for yourself.
Thank you everyone for watching today's video, and a huge thanks to Mannequin Mall for sending me these two fabulous dress forms to use for my projects and to be able to show all of you how to create and drape a custom bodice specifically for your size to make a dress or really any project you want to make in the future. So don't forget that they have given you all a special discount code. So if you click the link in the description below, you can get 10% off of your own dress form. And I have to say, getting to sew and create projects with a dress form truly is revolutionary and really does take your designs and your creations to a whole other level. So I hope that you get the opportunity to start designing with one. They are so fun to use. And if you were inspired by what you saw in today's video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already subscribed to my channel, hit the subscribe button so you stay updated on all the latest videos and projects in the future. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye.